that during the period when Mrs. Gandhi was in power, lots of laws, lots of executive action which were taken by Mrs. Gandhi's government were being called in question in the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court in so many cases were deciding against the government. Privy Purse case was also one of them, in which she had abolished Privy Purses, but her decision to abolish Privy Purses was struck down by the Supreme Court. So, well, one can say that there was a situation of confrontation between Indira Gandhi's government and the Supreme Court in a way. Well, when the British left and the Indian Independence Act was enacted by the British Parliament, the position was that there were many states, sovereign states in India, which were being ruled by princes in India, a large number of them, very large number of them. But the British were having suzerainty over them. So when they left in 1947, they withdrew their suzerainty, and therefore they became totally independent. Probably the British wanted that India should not emerge as a unified country, and there will be so many areas, big areas, small areas, like Hyderabad, Baroda, and so many other states, which will be ruled not by the elected government of India or by the state's elected government, but by independent rulers in those states. Well, after the constitution, Sardar Patel, who was the home minister, he very wisely integrated all the states into the Indian Union and got them to sign agreements of accession to India. Also, various other agreements were executed in order to impel, because they could not have been forced to do it. They were independent rulers having their constitutional rights under the international law. So therefore, one of the strategies which Sardar Patel acted upon was to induce them by promising them that each one of them will get a hefty privy purse for life. Namely, every year a huge amount would be paid by the government of India as a privy purse to the ruler. Also, various important properties will be treated as their own private properties. Some of them would be treated as state properties, which would come to the government of India, but other very vast properties also be treated as their private properties. This, to a very great extent, induced those independent princes to forget about their sovereignty, surrender their sovereignty the government of India, and thus India got integrated. Of course, in some states like Junagadh or Hyderabad, they were not getting induced merely by these inducements. So therefore, some kind of a force was also threatened to be applied. So by Sam Dam Dand Bhed, Sardar Patel integrated the whole of India, became one. The elected government under the constitution could enact laws for the whole of India, and the state governments could enact laws on certain subjects. So that is why privy purses, when they were abolished by the government, those princes went to the court mainly on the ground that this was a breach of a solemn promise made by the government of India to them, and the government could not take it away like this by withdrawing the privy purse. And the Supreme Court decided in their favor and struck down the abolition of privy purse, which compelled Mrs. Gandhi to amend the constitution and the Privy Purses were thereafter annulled by the Constitutional Amendment Act, which was also questioned.